together is a beginning. Keeping together is progress. Moving together is success. Shri Krishna College of Engineering and Technology takes immense happiness in welcoming you all to the inauguration of Atal-sponsored FTP on Artificial Intelligence, Machine Learning and Genomics. She is not a searcher for consensus, but a molder of consensus. May I now request Dr. S. Sophia, Head of the Department ECE, to deliver the welcome address. Over to ma'am.
Good morning, professors. With warm gratitude and great happiness, I welcome one and all for you this AICT-sponsored Atal FDP on Artificial Intelligence, Machine Learning and Genomics. On my behalf and on the team of SKCET, I welcome the chief guest, Dr. G. Janet, Principal SKCET, who is a motivating and guiding leader instrumental in organizing such events. Welcome, ma'am. With pleasure, I extend my warm welcome to Mr. S. Ramachandran, Infosys Knowledge Institute, Karnataka, who is the right person to open up and start the knowledge sharing events. We are happy that 200 participants from all over the nation have registered and are to attend this FTP on the online mode. Welcome, professors, and this FTP would be surely a platform to gain and share knowledge and establish the network. My lovely welcome note to all our fellow colleagues from Sri Krishna College of Engineering and Technology. At this point, I would place on record my welcome to all the 14 delegates from various academic institutions and industry for this sessions. Thank you, one and all. Learning should never be stopped and updated, and updation should continue.
Thank you, ma'am. Her actions has created a legacy that inspires others to dream more, learn more, do more, and become more. May I now request our most respected principal, madam, Dr. J. Janet, to deliver the chief guest address. Over to ma'am.
Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, morning ma'am.
Yeah, so am I audible?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So at the outset, it gives me immense pleasure that Sri Krishna College of Engineering and Technology, particularly EC Department of our institution, Sri Krishna College of Engineering and Technology, is organizing a five-day FDP on artificial intelligence, machine learning, and genomics. Well, I understand from the various slides, various presentations, from the experts' topics that I simply browse through, it's going to be really an exciting session. All power-packed sessions, which is extending its horizon across all applications for that matter. You know very well that AI has become the norm of today. AI has permeated every field from automation to genomics and whatnot. And the sessions with the neural network training and AI, applications which is getting extended across all fields. I feel that this five-day FDP will equip all the faculty fraternity to launch launch into this AI horizon and seamlessly deliver the content to their students on the future topics in AI and machine learning as well. And I am really grateful and thankful to the Atal Academy for giving us this opportunity to launch this one-of-a-kind unique courses. I'm grateful and I thank all the experts for going to handle various sessions. I congratulate the team headed by Dr. Sophia and the entire ECE team in organize and the coordinator, Dr. Sasi Priya, who's organizing this FDP. Kudos to you. And I encourage all the participants to really get all the key takeaways from the various sessions lined out on all these 5 days and make it meaningful and very useful in their life. Well, I would like to end up with a quote. You know, the opportunity to excel, the platform to make it happen, the curiosity to learn things is all that's needed for success, if you have to achieve success. And the right platform, the opportunity, and the curiosity is all right here and right now. So let's make use of this opportunity to excel and flourish higher. Wish you all the very best, team. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, Thank you, ma'am. It is a great honor for me to introduce and welcome our guest of honor, Mr. Ramachandran sir. He is a principal consultant in Infosys Knowledge Institute, the research and thought leadership team in Infosys. His focus has been on the application of emerging technologies and management concepts in the industry, specifically in the manufacturing vertical. His current topics of interest are Industry 4.0, Future of Work, Circular Economy and Servitization. He has co-authored a book with Professor L. Prasad, IIM Bangalore, titled Neo-Skilling for Digital Transformation, published by Valet India. He is a mechanical engineer with a master's in production engineering. He has completed his MBA from IIM Bangalore in 2009. Over to Sir.
Thank you, Tefila. A very good morning to each one of you. Happy Onam to those of you who are celebrating the festival today. On behalf of the management of Sri Krishna College of Engineering, the principal, the HOD, and the organizing team, I welcome each one of you participants to this AICTE-sponsored FDP training program, which is very focused on artificial intelligence. I think the timing of this session is really good because of the COVID-19 pandemic, obviously. So as all of you know, artificial intelligence has been around for decades. It has been in, very popular in universities for academic type of research since the 1950s. But in the last, I would say, 5 years, it has proved what it is capable of doing for the industry also. So there has been a lot of practical applications of artificial intelligence. But again, the issue was organizations have done very small pilots. Even large organizations, world leaders, have been struggling to see what are the use cases where artificial intelligence can be effectively used. In fact, in the last few years, there has also been a lot of negative coverage that artificial intelligence has received, which is because of two reasons. One is out of the fear that it is going to take away employment, right? So that is something obvious. Business leaders are going to expect return on investment from investments in artificial intelligence. And one of the effects of it is going to probably be loss of jobs, but we'll look at that. That has received a lot of negative attention from media. The other one is because of the inherent bias in artificial intelligence. So as all of you know, as academicians, artificial intelligence is more like a black box. So it may not be able to explain what all the decisions that it took. So there has been a lot of negative media coverage again for areas like facial recognition, where there was a lot of racial bias because of the data used for training of these algorithms. The bias that was inherent when humans were doing these jobs got carried away into AI. So algorithms like facial recognition were banned by specific cities. Even areas of application like loan processing, where it could decide whether to accept or reject an application, looked like it seemed to have inherent bias. So that also received a lot of negative media attention. But now, because of COVID-19, I feel that artificial intelligence has become more of a necessity. So as teaching professionals, you play a very important role in this journey. College graduates will be expected to know basics of artificial intelligence and machine learning when they get into the industry. It is going to become something like usage of a spreadsheet for calculations or a PowerPoint. So students, engineering education, I would say, is incomplete without basic programming or using Python or R language for even basics of machine learning algorithms. Even experienced professionals are under a lot of pressure now in the industry to learn and pick up this. I'm not sure if you have industry participants in this session. We'll go into the details of this in the deep dive sessions that we have. The organizers have lined up an array of amazing topics that are highly relevant today, both for industry and academy. We spoke about the negative media coverage that artificial intelligence has received. So what is the way out? Because the technology has proved what it is capable of doing. So companies that effectively use these technologies will have a competitive edge. They will be able to win the competition. So do they worry about employment of their employees, or what is the way out? So the answer for it is reskilling. Reskilling for experienced domain experts. Their domain knowledge is still important, but on top of it, they need to learn these recent AI technologies. So reskilling is going to be very important for experienced professionals. College graduates need to make sure that artificial intelligence is part of their curriculum, whatever be the department, whatever be the discipline they're going to study. So that's where this type of a program is very useful at this point of time. Like I said, I think the timing of this session is very, very interesting. The way people are going to look at artificial intelligence is going to be very different now because of COVID-19. There are many use cases which we'll see in the later sessions where artificial intelligence is definitely required. There may not be any other way to help us because there are so many unknowns today in COVID-19. Large organizational leaders, even national leaders are worried about how the situation is going to look like after 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, or even 6 months and 1 year, both from a society perspective and also from an industrial perspective. So I'm pretty sure these sessions will be very interactive to exchange insights. Industry people will be happy to share what is happening in the industry, and there can be a good exchange of insights between the academy and the industry. So I look forward to these sessions. I wish you all the best. I wish the organizing team and all the participants very insightful sessions where you share knowledge, where you take away a lot of insights from knowledge gained from these experts. I look forward to attending this session. I wish you all the best, and I thank the organizers for inviting me for this session. Thank you so much. Back to you.
It was wonderful listening to you, sir. Thank you for your thought-provoking words. May I now request Dr. S. Shashipriya, Coordinator, Atal FDP, Professor, Department of ECE, to deliver vote of thanks. Over to ma'am.
Thank you, Defila. A graceful and happy morning to one and all present here. It is my honor to propose the vote of thanks on this occasion. I, on behalf of the management, principal, and the entire fraternity of the college, first of all, I extend my sincere thanks to the AICT Training and Learning Atal Academy for providing financial support in organizing this 1 week online FDP on artificial intelligence, machine learning, and genomics. I would like to express my deep gratitude to our MD Madam, Mrs. S. Mallarvelli, Chairperson and Managing Trustee, Sri Krishna Institutions, for rendering us with all possible logistic support towards organizing this event. I express my sincere thanks to our beloved Principal Madam and Chief Guest of the day, Dr. J. Janet, who is the guiding force and the source of inspiration in organizing various events. Thank you, ma'am. I wholeheartedly thank the guest of honor, Mr. S. Ramachandran, Principal Consultant, Author, Speaker, Infosys Knowledge Institute, Karnataka, for sparing this time amid this busy schedule and to grace the occasion. Thank you, sir, for a very thought-provoking and interesting address. Also thank our HOD, Dr. S. Sophia, for her guidance and moral support in conducting this FDP. Thank you, ma'am. I also thank the present media for your support. I express my gratitude to all the speakers from industries and academicians from foreign and Indian universities for accepting our invitation and delivering a lecture in this FDP. I would place on record my hearty thanks to all our faculty, committee members, and technical staff for their cooperation and support in organizing this program. It has been our pleasure to host all the participants of the FDP. I record my heartfelt thanks to all the participants for selecting our FDP. The final word of thanks to all the people who have directly or indirectly helped to make this event successful. Once again, I thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. We have come to the end of the inaugural session. We will have the next session at 11:30 a.m. on contemporary applications of artificial intelligence, machine learning in the post-COVID-19 era, handled by Mr. Ramachandran sir, Principal Consultant, Infosys Knowledge Institute, Bangalore. Thank you.